Oh, the weather outside is frightful, but the fire is so delightful. And since we've no place to go, let it snow, let it snow, let it snow.
Hey pals, it's Michael here. We're here at Hollywood Studios. It's Christmas time. I want to see what they've got going on in here for Christmas. I know everyone's freaking out about this whole Rise of the Resistance thing. I don't think I'm going to be able to get in for that ride, but we'll give it a shot. Let's see what happens.
Oh, well, there's my answer. Oh, well.
I can't be all that surprised. I mean, the park opened at 7. It's like 8:30, so... yeah, of course they'd be all gone. We'll try next time. In the meantime, though, I want to see what kind of Christmas stuff they got going on here. This is one of my favorite places to go at Christmas time, and I'll have you see why. Yeah, as you can see, Christmas is hopping here at Hollywood Studios. I just love all the retro decorations and style that they have here. I mean, this place just looks gorgeous. Man, even the stop signs are lit up for Christmas. Look at it, red and green. I love all these old school Hummel decorations they have everywhere. They're huge. Yeah, they remind me a lot of the ones that my grandma would have all around her house at Christmas time. They were always a little borderline creepy, but wouldn't be Christmas without them. Something else I wanted to do while I was here is see what the wait times are like elsewhere around the parks. I mean, everyone's talking about Rise of the Resistance, and oh, it's the only thing that's worth riding right now. I beg to differ, and let's go see what... Toy Story Land's looking like. Woody's got his jaunty little scarf on. And there's decorations and ornaments and everything all over his stuff. Buzz is wearing a Santa hat. Oh, I love it! Oh, and you see up there, Rex has got antlers. I'm a reindeer! So Slinky Dog's had an 80-minute wait. Jessie's out. She's got her little festive vest on. Oh, and Toy Story Mania was an 85-minute wait, so... yeah, it's definitely busy today, but not too bad. Let's go inside Galaxy's Edge and see what we can see for Smuggler's Run.
Can you hear everybody's feet squeaking everywhere? Yeah, it just rained a little while ago, and everything's very wet and very new and very slippery. So keep that in mind when you come here, that the floors are slick. Typically, when you walk in from Toy Story, everybody starts walking to the right. I'm going to go to the left and head towards Ronto's. You know what time it is. Ooh, there's a wraparound line for Ronto's, so... I guess it's not that time. Oh, but come on. Coming down these stairs and seeing this bad boy hunk of junk my foot. Oh, she is gorgeous. Oh, I love it here so much. So it's a 70-minute wait time. Not too bad. And single rider's open, so that's nice. And there's like a film on the balls. There's like completely empty, though. Ew. That's better. Okay, so first sip of the blue milk since opening week. So let's try this. Yeah, tastes exactly as I remember. Oh, I love it so much, it's so good. It tastes like white gummy bears to me. I remember the flavor of white gummy bears as a kid, and that's exactly what it tastes like to me. Oh, it's so good. You know, one thing I'm surprised about, there's no Baby Yoda like puppeteering going on. You see all those puppets. They have an animal kingdom, all the different wintertime animals and so forth. How do they not have a Baby Yoda puppet yet? That would be like the number one photo op right now in this park. Just like the Hasbro toys, they're kind of a little behind the eight ball on that one, so maybe they'll fix it soon. I wanted to see if they were going to have any kind of Life Day decorations in Galaxy's Edge, but so far I'm not seeing anything. Or am I? I mean, what do Life Day
the decorations look like.
One of my favorite paths to take through here is through the marketplace. I mean, just all the detail and artifacts and the smells and the way everything feels just going through here. I mean, you feel like you are in another world. I just walked through here, this is the biggest smile on my face. I look like an idiot, but I don't care. I'm an idiot that's happy. All right, it's official. It's Ronto time. Right, little buddy? Ronto time. Ronto. 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 I like to think that's what he's saying in his head. Now, there's not a lot of places around here when it's busy to eat in privacy, but if you know where to look, there's a little corner or two. All right. Oh, you want to see this? Roll that beautiful Ronto footage. Excuse me for a minute. Now, one thing I've learned, the morning Ronto wrap, not as good as the regular all-day available Ronto wrap. With the pork and the slaw and the dressing, it is far superior. So if you come here and you're going to get a Ronto, get the OG.
All right, that's enough of that. Is there any on my face? No? We're good? Okay. All right, let's go check out the rest of the park.
I love all the early naysayers saying, oh, this park is a joke, and they opened it wrong, and everything here is, you know, one and done, and it's got no repeatability. Really? You've clearly not experienced it the way that the rest of us have experienced it. This park is absolutely fantastic. I will come here every chance I get from here on out. This is definitely my favorite land that they have built next to Pandora. For sure.
And this year for the holidays, they've got special popcorn buckets. The alien popcorn bucket, which is usually in his blue uniform, he's actually in these little red plaid pajamas. How adorable. And they've got the Christmas tree there as well.
Here, walking down Sunset Boulevard, it feels like you've taken a time machine back to the 1950s. Strolling down Sunset Boulevard during Christmas time. Oh, I love all the little stars. Everything lights up at night. And they have the snow machines that come blowing the snow everywhere, which is really cool. And here at Carthay Circle, you can meet Santa Claus. He's actually right in there. You get your picture taken and tell him what you want for Christmas. But while Sunset Boulevard's great, Hollywood Boulevard is where it's at. I mean, there's just something extra special about how they've decorated this area. I just absolutely love it. Growing up as a kid, Christmas Eve was always spent at my grandparents' house, and this is exactly what it sounded like. This is exactly what it smelled like. This is exactly what the decor was like. I think that's what I love coming here so much, because it just feels like a little moment from my past. And I hope they never change how they decorate Hollywood Studios at Christmas time. It is just perfect. All right, well, that's gonna do it for me here at Hollywood Studios. I love Christmas time. It just, everything about this park and everything about what they do with the style and the music and the food and everything about it. It's just, I love this park. Anyway, I'm gonna go for now. So thanks for watching. Don't forget to be a pal. Make sure you like and subscribe and hit the bell. Find out when we do the next video. Till then, thanks again for watching. Bye.